know nothing about the horrors of this industry. When they learn about it, they do not stand for it. This is the beginning of permanent change.
Thousands of these mills across the United States, supplying stores with 500,000 puppies a year. It's all about quantity and profit, with little, if any, care given to the individual animals. In fact, the conditions common to most mills are so inhumane, the dogs are left in various states of physical and mental anguish. Just how cruel is the pet shop business? See for yourself.
They're crated up and kept pregnant year-round, never getting exercise or a human touch.
Saving dogs from so-called puppy mills. But he says this has gone too far. He's scared for his team's safety after a threatening phone call was traced from LaFleur County to his office.
One of them recently here in the last couple of weeks, there was gunshots fired over him.
Oklahoma has a long way to go to get past sad images like this. Board members have been to more than 200 operations across
the state. There is not another industry in the world that is as cruel as my industry.
It's about money and it's about greed. They could care less where these dogs came from as long as they're making money. That is all they care about.
If you ask me the question, how many pet store puppies have a disease, I would say 100%.
In my mind, you're committing an act of cruelty when you buy that puppy in the pet store, because what you're doing is, when you buy that puppy, you're sentencing its mother to a lifetime of misery in a puppy mill.
We're bought at branches of Russo's Pet Store, where salespeople said the dogs were from California and even provided documentation. But the owners later discovered they were smuggled from Mexico.
When you go to Fashion Island, you don't expect to be buying a $5 dog off of the back of a truck that's just come in from Mexico.
Hidden dangers.
Most of these puppies are too young. You know, they have underlying diseases and illnesses that you can't really detect, you know, in a 5-minute inspection on a puppy.
Here, put some on your puppy.
Because the truth is horrific, and they know that if we found out that these dogs came from these abused living conditions, that we would stop buying these puppies.
It's not me, it's not my family in your head. this was, unfortunately, a typical day at Pick of the Litter.
Talking about dirty cages, wire floors, rusty. You're talking about food that is contaminated, water filled with algae sometimes, dogs that are emaciated. It's a horrible, horrible existence for man's best friend.
This is the life of a puppy mill dog.
Evidence, we went in with the SPCA and busted them.
It does make you sick to think what people would do for money. That's all it is, it's just money.
People like you are going to keep on doing this kind of shit.
I wasn't in it to begin with. I didn't want to do it anyway.
You're not finding yourself another job, and you tell that jerk.
I have my job.
You tell Tran Su, find himself another living.
I have my job.
Because if not, he's going to be right here with you. And I want to do what I can to make sure you don't get out and he gets in. That's my word to you, because you know why you lied to me this whole interview?
I did not lie to you.
You lied to me this whole interview. Why is this happening with the puppy mills coming out here? Why?
Well, puppy mills would not exist if pet shops did not sell live animals. They all come from puppy mills. They all come from this filth, this inhumane treatment. Don't do it.
Oh, I know.
No! dogs. Some of these animals likely living their entire lives in small wire enclosures with barely enough room to turn around.
They're being manufactured the same way that radios and appliances are being manufactured.
These commercial, money-driven breeding facilities are known as puppy mills. It's estimated there are 10,000 in the U.S. alone, many located in the Midwest, and many supplying small pups to pet stores across the country, including right here in California.
You end up with a lot of sick animals being sold through these pet stores, and unfortunately, it's the consumer that bears the burden.
Consumers have a right to know, before they purchase a dog as a pet, where that dog is coming from. And in many cases, we found they just won't tell you.
That they have their AKC papers, that they're registered, that they came from a farm, that the parents are running miles on this green grass all day long, and that they would never, ever buy from a puppy mill. So the not just the lies, but how in depth these lies were and how these stories were obviously scripted, it was just appalling for me.
Look at the matting on this dog. Like a jacket. Hi. These nails are extremely overgrown. A human being did this to her. We've been out of here all day. And our job is to rescue these animals and get them off the property and hold it together. But we're about a half an hour from being out here. And it's hard to hold it together when you're holding something like this. We've just introduced you to a world that most people don't know about. A world hidden behind websites and pet stores. This is the world for these dogs. For weeks, months, and many of them years. And unfortunately, it was too late for those who have lived their entire lives in this facility. Many of these animals were in dire straits. How do you feel?
We're happy that we're able to help the animals today.